mamahahanda. Walang maiiwan. Sama-sama lipad. Kami ang pangarap.
Sa hamong kinakarap, patuloy na aangat.
Edukasyon para sa lahat. Sulong.
Sulong.
Sulong edukalidad.
You're entering a whole new world, but do not
pagdating araw sa mga cute na itlang mag-aaral sa
video. Diyan nagtatapos ang ating maikling pagsusulit.
Sabik na ba kayo sa ating bagong aralin?
Babasahin ko na ang mga katanungan.
Handa na ba kayo? Ito ang Tepid Radyo. Radyo Eskwela.
Member KBP, kapisanan ng mga pampaaralang broadcaster sa buong Pilipinas.
Great day, grade 9 learners! This is your School on the Air for Arts 9. I am your teacher Chai, your partner in learning through radio. Before we start, I want you to set yourselves ready. Prepare also your learning activity sheets, for they will be our guides in the discussion of today's lesson. Now, I want you to bring out your learning activity sheets on arts for the third quarter titled Arts of the Neoclassic Period. Make sure that you are holding the learning activity sheets titled Arts of the Neoclassic Period. Are you holding them now? I know that you are all excited for the new concepts which you will be learning today. Are you ready? This is your first episode in your subject, MAPE 9, particularly in arts. And at the end of this episode, you are expected to identify and describe the highlights and style of the neoclassical period. I hope that you have the enthusiasm in enriching your knowledge in arts. Before we sail further, may we listen to this important reminder.
Bridges are flooded and rendered impassable in Cagayan.
Napansin-pansin, talagang napakalakas ng current. Mahirap lumakad.
Nalubog sa baha ang maraming bayan sa Luzon.
Marami ang natrap sa kanilang mga bubong.
Naging pahirapan din ang rescue operation.
Minsan nang sinubok, pinalubog, ngunit aahon. Ang kagawaran ng edukasyon kasama ang iba pang mga ahensya ng pamahalaan ay hinihikayat ang bawat mag-aaral, guro at buong komunidad na makiisa sa mga proyektong pangkalikasan at kahandaan sa sakuna upang bangungot ng nakaraan ay hindi na muling maranasan.
Maging makakalikasan.
Maging handa.
Maging alerto.
Isang paalala mula sa DepEd, DENR, NDRRMC at nang himpilang ito.
We are back to our School on the Air. Neoclassic period is an age born after the rejection from Rococo and late Baroque style. Neoclassic influence was still visible through paintings, sculptures, and other artworks adopted by well-known artists internationally and conveyed the traits and characteristics of the period. Neoclassical movement coincided with the 18th century Age of Reason, also known as the Age of Enlightenment. The art style in this period was brought about by the renewed interest in Greek and Roman classics. Neoclassical pieces such as paintings, sculpture, architecture, generally portrayed Roman history, which elevated the Roman heroes. The word neoclassic came from the Greek word neos, meaning new, and the Latin word classicus, which is similar in meaning to the English phrase first class. The Western movement in decorative and visual arts was called neoclassicism. It also applies to literature, theater, music, and architecture that were influenced by the classical art and culture of ancient Greece and ancient Rome. Now, can you easily recognize a neoclassical piece from other masterpieces in the different art movements? Aha! For you to be able to recognize them easily, here are some of the characteristics of neoclassic arts. First, masterpieces in neoclassicism portray Roman history. Artists borrowed inspirational subjects from Roman Republican history in order to celebrate the values of simplicity, austerity, heroism, and estoicism, which are the same values that were being asserted at the time in connection with the French struggle for liberty. Second, artworks are in a formal composition. This means art pieces in this period are made using formal elements like lines, shapes, form, tone, texture, pattern, color, and composition. The third characteristic is the use of straight lines rather than curved lines. Artists use straight lines, specifically the diagonal lines, to show the peak of an emotion or moment. The fourth characteristic is that classical artists observe minimal use of colors. And lastly, classicism uses classic geostructure. Now, for you to be able to understand better, let us compare neoclassicism with that of classicism. Do you know the difference? This one is for you. In neoclassicism, this is the time wherein there is a renewed interest in classical ideals and forms that influence European and American society through idea, politics, and fine arts during the 18th and 19th century. It also refers to the art movements created after but inspired by the ancient time. I repeat, it also refers to the art forms created after but inspired by the ancient times. This period was derived from the classicism movement. This is the period wherein Greek and human principles and styles were reflected in society. Be careful not to interchange the two terms. Classicism refers to the art forms produced in antiquity or inspired by it afterward, while neoclassicism always refers to the art forms inspired by ancient times but created later. Again, classicism refers to the art forms produced in antiquity or inspired by it afterward, while neoclassicism always refers to the art forms inspired by ancient times but created later. We are done with discussing the nature, background, and characteristic of neoclassic period. Did you understand the lesson? Great! For now, listen to this important reminder and we will have the recap in a short quiz when we come back.
Nay, gusto kong mag-aral.
Hindi! Walang mag-aaral.
Pero Nay...
Magandang araw po! Enrollment na naman po! Magsi-senior high school na si Chichay ngayong taon, di po ba? Mag-i-enroll ho ba siya?
Naku ma'am, hindi na po. Sayang lang ang panahon. Masyadong mahaba yung dalawang taon na yan sa senior high school. Magtatrabaho lang din naman
ako, Nay. Alam po ba ninyo na may tatlong exits ang senior high school?
May tatlong exits ang senior high school. Koleyo, trabaho at negosyo. Negosyo para sa mga magpapatuloy sa pag-aaral. Trabaho para sa mga nais maghanap buhay. At negosyo para sa mga nais magsimula ng kanilang pagkakakitaan.
Kaya Nay, i-enroll na ninyo si Chichay sa susunod na pasukan. Dahil sa senior high school, kinabukasan mo ay garantisado.
Isang mahalagang paalala mula sa DepEd at ng himpilang ito.
I am back. Earlier, we talked about neoclassic period. We learned that neoclassic came from the Greek word neos, which means new, and Latin word classicus, which also means first class. We also said that neoclassical movement coincided with the 18th century Age of Reason, also known as the Age of Enlightenment. The art style in this period was brought about by the renewed interest in Greek and Roman classics. Neoclassical art pieces such as paintings, sculpture, and architecture generally portrayed Roman history, which elevated the Roman heroes. We also said that neoclassic masterpieces have distinctive characteristic and they are, first, they portray Roman history. Second, made with formal composition. Third, they use straight, particularly diagonal lines to show the peak of an emotion or moment. Fourth, they use simple local colors. And lastly, artists observe classic geostructure. Are you still on the run? Let's continue. To see whether you listened well in our discussion, I want you to bring out a clean sheet of paper and answer the following questions. Again, bring out a clean sheet of paper and answer the following questions. Number 1. Neoclassic comes from the Greek word neos and Latin word classicus. What does the Greek word neos mean? I repeat, neoclassic comes from the Greek word neos and Latin word classicus. What does the Greek word neos mean? Number 2. Classicus is a Latin word which means blank. Again, classicus is a Latin word which means blank. For the last number, list down the characteristic of neoclassical arts. I repeat, for the last number, list down the characteristic of neoclassical arts. Don't forget to write your name at the upper left corner of your paper. Pass your answers to your teacher during the retrieval day scheduled in your respective barangays or in the respective drop points. If you have questions regarding our topic for this episode, please feel free to message your teacher through Messenger, Gmail, text or SMS, or you may write them in a piece of paper and attach to your answer sheets. Join me again in our next learning episode, which will be about neoclassical painting. Stay tuned always. And this has been your learning buddy, Chai, reminding you to stay safe. Thank you for listening. Goodbye!
Ang iyong panglaw sa dekalidad na edukasyon.
Kasama mo.
Kaagapay mo ngayong bagong normal na edukasyon.
Ito ang Radyo Eskwela.
Radyo Eskwela.
Edukasyon para sa lahat. Sulong edukalidad. Radyo Eskwela.
Radyo Eskwela.
Member KBP, kapisanan ng mga pampaaralang broadcaster sa buong Pilipinas.
Kinigman.